Hey, we got some errands to run today. I'm gonna go do some thrift shopping and go to Walmart, see if I get harassed again. But they have some plants there I want to get for the homestead. Stay tuned. Hello, welcome back to Pine Meadows Hobby Farm. I'm your host, Jerry Hansen. I'm doing some errands today. I came down to my favorite thrift shop, one of my favorite thrift shops. I'm looking for a stand, a kind of a plant stand type table. And I'm also still looking for those oars. And what else am I looking for? Oh yeah, I got to build a gate because I'm finally getting to the fence around my backyard to deer proof it, but I want to build a new gate and I want to look for a feature that will go be built into the gate itself to, well, you know me, I'm eccentric. So let's go in and let's do some exploring and see what treasures we can hunt for. Since I am looking for oars, here's some life jackets. $5. For the boat. Perfect. Looks like it holds a candle. That'd be cool for the garden. Thank you.
a cool desk. $60. $20 for this basket. Nah. No worries. Just perfect.
Good.
Could I get my veteran's discount, please?
Yes, I do. Thank you so much for your service there.
Thank you.
For you right now, okay?
Well, how about that? I ran to my friends, Jim and Naomi. My wife and I got married in their living room. So they're really good friends, and they just live right down the road from us. Wonderful couple, beautiful couple. So that's always nice running into some friends. Off to Walmart to possibly get harassed and buy some shrubs. Okay, we're at Walmart. Let's go in and see how this happens.
Let's see if their machines are calibrated. I mainly have to buy plants that are deer resistant, but here's the lilac bushes.
There's lilacs. I want two of those.
And a hydrangea. I want... A deer will eat hydrangea if they're really hungry, but they won't eat lilac. Now, I have raspberries, hydrangea. Oh, they have white hydrangea, and they have blue hydrangea. I want a blue hydrangea also. Well, I guess it depends on the soil, on whether it goes blue or not. All right. Oh, I have plenty of strawberries in my garden. Thank you very much.
I'm very excited about those. I'm going to get one.
I wanted a couple of rhododendrons. 848. Let's get two rhododendrons. And a rosemary for my spice garden. Okay, my herb garden. All right, that's it. Come on. Their things are calibrated appropriately. That makes me very happy.
Oh, it's so nice to be able to walk in and out of there. I used two entrances because I had to use the restroom. Anyway, I had to go. I got my plants. Good bargain on these plants. Now I can plant those in a chicken yard where I'm putting up fencing. And also that's in close proximity to the bees, so that it gives the bees some food. And they're deer resilient, which is a good thing. What I meant by continually being harassed at Walmart Yeah. Every time I walk in there and walk out, I would set off the alarms with my pacemaker. And they'd always stop and detain me at the gates, which is wrong. You can't be detained. A pacemaker can't be detained at the gates because it can cause a blood clot and cause the patient to have either a pulmonary embolism or a stroke. So I went to corporate and also talked to the person in charge of that here at this store. And it was Valentine's Day. I talked to them about that. That's funny, dealing with the heart on Valentine's Day. So they fixed it. So I got to shop without harassment. Nice. So let me explain the boat, the porta boat. I featured it in one of my treasure hunting series on the playlist I have on treasure hunting. I got that free. It came attached to the fifth wheel, and this is what it looks like when it's put together and taken apart. It's kind of a unique little boat. Well, that's why I'm trying to find the oars for, and also trying to find the rest of the stuff I need for it. I got everything now. I already have life jackets, so I figured two more won't hurt. So that's what the porta boat is, and that's my little boat project. I'm going to go ahead and put the rosemary here in the front because this whole area right here is going to be basically an herb garden. And since my hydrangea are prone to get maybe ate by deer, I'm going to go ahead and put them in the backyard. I got one here and I've got one over here in the corner. So this fence that I'm repairing and rebuilding the new gate, that will be flanked by or framed by hydrangeas. And then for now I put my lilacs up here. We're going to plant one lilac over here. We're going to plant the other one up front, but we got a rhododendron there and a rhododendron over there. They'll be on the inside of the fence once I get the chicken fence in, and then the beehives are over there. So all the flowers, the lilacs, excellent bee food for the bees. I have this part of the chicken fence in. I just have to fasten it down, tighten it up, and get some more supports in there and get this flush into the ground. I gotta dig a hole in there and I'll dig it out with a tractor. We'll see how it goes. So with my treasure hunting that I've been doing at the thrift stores and finding the different things I need for the homestead on a budget is coming together. I also found those plants cheaper at Walmart than I could at a nursery. Well, I'm Jerry Hansen, your host. This is Pine Meadows Hobby Farm, a frugal homestead tech high on the Cascade Ranges of the Pacific Northwest. Please stay tuned to more videos. You could do that by subscribing and clicking that bell icon that alerts you to new videos as I upload them. Give us a thumbs up. Click that share button. Sharing my videos on your social media platforms helps us out. Leave a comment if you will, or a tip, a trick. I like those. Be safe, always be kind. We'll see you guys in the next adventure. Bye-bye now.